I just like to, elaborate a bit about this pre-testing bit also before I come to your question. So, in fact, for surgery in the NHS, what the recommendation is that we could do a combination of RT-PCR and CT scan, CT chest, to identify a patient. It's not a foolproof solution. We know that there is a 30% false negative rate. But on the other hand, repeating the RT-PCR test might actually improve the odds of actually finding a case. Now, it is a fact that, a patient can actually acquire COVID during the course of the illness, during the course of the treatment. But perhaps the chances of that are less during the lockdown period. I really, it will be something that we'll have to deal with once the lockdown actually opens up, is not there, and then how we are going to deal with it is a different question altogether. But social distancing norms will possibly remain in place even when we are not in lockdown situation. Now, coming to this particular issue of a patient developing COVID positivity while on treatment. So if we look at the guidelines that have come from China, they recommend that if the patient has mild symptoms, and if we see the guidelines that have come from ASTRO and ESTRO, the recommendation is that if the patient is asymptomatic or has mild symptoms, but in place that this particular patient would have to be treated with full PPE. That should be the last patient of the day. And then there has to be the cleaning that is required has to be as per norms when dealing with COVID positive patients. Now, is it actually practical? How are we going to deal with it? How are we going to deal with the air conditioning? We understand that even the AC is a problem. I have wondered whether when you're treating this patient as the last patient, are you going to switch off the air conditioning? I don't have the answer to that. But the guidelines from China have actually suggested that we should continue to treat these patients if they are not symptomatic, but that we should treat them as the last patient of the day.
So I will add to what Dr. Sapna has said, that continuing with radiation is option and taking the patient as the last patient is a good option. However, from the medical oncology point of view, if any such patient who is on active anti-cancer treatment, even if it is an oral treatment in the form of tyrosine kinase inhibitors or gemcitabine oral chemotherapy drugs, I would like to suspend all chemotherapy treatments till the time we steer clear of the presence of the infection. If it is a COVID infection, then we have to wait till the time the patient is on the path of recovery. Only then we need to restart with the treatment. I don't see there would be any exception to this, because in the COVID time, whatever the patients are on treatment right now, they are either patients who are on hematological malignancies or who are on adjuvant treatment in which we are giving a curative intent treatment. With the incidence of mortality being so high in the active cancer patients on treatment, I would say simply suspend off all the chemotherapy related treatment, even if it is an old treatment, till the time we have the confirmation that patient is not having an active infection or till the time there is a recovery documented by a laser test with the development of the IgG antibodies.